to the stage. He's actually he's kind of a local. Y'all make some noise for Bubba Que.
How y'all doing? Well, tax season, one of my favorite times of the year, let me tell you. Last year, when I got my taxes, I decided I wanted to buy me a truck. I had me a little Honda Civic, and I didn't think that you could look really redneck in a Honda Civic. So I looked online, went on Craigslist, went on Facebook Flea Market, and I was looking for me a truck. And this little girl hit me up, and she said, "My uncle has a truck out at Flat Rock Crossroads, and if you go out there, he wants to look at it." So I go out there expecting it to be this older guy because she said it was her uncle. So I go up to the thing, and this gorgeous, stunning stud of a man walks out of the building. Probably about 35 years old, ain't got no shirt on, sweating, grease all over him. I walk right up to him and said, "I can take my teeth out. Do you know I got $500 off that truck?" Now this year, when I get my income tax back, I'm gonna do something really gay with it. I'm gonna go and see Bette Midler and Hello Dolly in Broadway up in New York City. I'm gonna take my friend Straight Kyle with me. Now I call him Straight Kyle because I don't want anybody thinking we're together. He's a hairy kind of boy, and I don't really like hairy kind of boys. You understand? We was camping one time and Bigfoot came into our campsite and I saw them hairy buns and it just scarred me for life. But I will tell you this, if the truck's big enough, I'll think about it. I ain't never been to New York City, but I did live up north for a few years. I was dating this boy that was from Massachusetts. And Mom and Daddy wasn't really upset that I was dating a boy. They was kind of upset I was dating a Yankee. But anyway, I decided I would go up there and see how it was. And he was pretty nice. There's a lot of really nice people up there. They think that we are the funniest people in the world while we talk. And I just make up shit to, you know, say, these are sayings we say down south. I'd be like, "Damn, it's harder than a blistered pussy in a pepper patch." They'd be like, "What's that mean?" I'm like, "I don't know, it's just something we say." But I have to say that the people up north have a somewhat bad view of us down south. They ain't got really much to go by. They got Gone with the Wind and Honey Boo Boo. I mean, Gone with the Wind. You know. But Honey Boo Boo, when did we decide to put white trash on television? I tell you. But I came back home. Me and my boyfriend broke up. He left me for a 19-year-old Filipino boy. More power to him. But I came back home and I was real depressed and I thought I'd look for me a job and I got the newspaper out. And on the front of the paper it said they were having a cornhole tournament. And I thought, "Damn, there's something I do." Well, do you know that that is a game now where they toss little pans of balls and stuff? That I thought, well, why in the hell would they name it that? Because for years it's meant something else. So next we're gonna come up with a game called Doggy Style. Doggies and the Wild Kids and stuff. They were cute. I recently started dating this little boy, Dylan. He's cute as hell. And it's kind of like, I wasn't sure it was gonna work because he's an Alabama Roll Tide fan and I'm a Tennessee Go Vols fan. So it's, you know, they say opposites don't get together, but I think they do. It's like star-crossed lovers, like Romeo and Juliet. And Romeo and Juliet is kind of like a redneck love story anyway. They was 14, they got married, they had access to guns, knives, and poisons. So pretty much redneck love story right there. So I thought I was gonna be real romantic and go up to his house and do this whole Romeo speech to him. So I went up right to his window and I was like, "What light through yonder window breaks? It is the east and Dylan is the west." And he came to the window and he said, "Bubba, would you shut up? You're gonna wake up everybody in the trailer park."